Hey everyone! So I figured it would be a good idea for me to share with you some things that I have learned about working from home in an effort to help you learn from home. Because it's, you know, not going to be quite like a snow day or two or three. We're going to be here for some weeks, and it's possible that it can be even longer than the month that we already have set out for us. So, with that in mind, here are my tips for making learning from home a little more efficient and a little more tolerable. Number one, get dressed. That's right. I know you don't have to. I know that you get to stay at home, and so you could stay in your flannel PJs and your fuzzy slippers, but in the morning, when it's time to get up and get dressed. Take a shower, brush your hair, brush your teeth, put on clothes, maybe even shoes. You might consider, if you don't like to wear shoes around your house, maybe consider getting a pair of slippers that can be like your house shoes, so to speak. But get up and get dressed. It does something different for your mindset. It makes you feel more like you are ready to go and do and accomplish and be productive. And all of those things will be better for your overall well-being. So get up and get dressed. I think it was John Acuff had a quote that was, flannel feels like failure by day three. And so the first couple days might be fine, but it starts to get really depressing staying in your pajamas all day. Number two, make a schedule. Now, some of you, your school is doing this for you. You are having to log in at certain times and complete things by certain times. But if not, make sure that you have a schedule. Here's what I'm going to do between the hours of, here's what I'm going to be, when is lunch? You know, schedule all this stuff, because that's what you would do anyway if you were at school. You would be operating on a schedule to keep your mind and your body moving from one thing to the next instead of just being sedentary and starting to collapse into fatigue and, again, depression, which is a real threat here. Number three. Stand up, get up out of your chair. Every hour, get up out of your chair. Even if that means that you're in the middle of a class, stand up and read a chapter from history, or do a few math problems, you know, leaning over your desk. But stand up, do jumping jacks, do push-ups, run in place, march in place, do something to get you moving every hour of the day, all right? Number four, I think we're up to four now, right? Set timers. Set timers and take breaks. So if you are gonna work on something for a specific amount of time and then you know that I should go off and do something else, set a timer for yourself and, you know, give it a little bit of wiggle room. Oh, I'm right in the middle of this. I'm almost done. It's like I've got another 5 minutes and then I'm finished. Okay, fine. Set another timer for 5 minutes and then be done with it and go on to the next thing. But set something to help you remember to shift gears. Again, you already have this at school. A bell rings at the end of the period. It tells you it's time to go do something else. So set a timer for yourself. Number five, do something analog. We are gonna be going all digital. We're gonna be going to digital lessons, you and I. We're gonna be going to digital classes. You're gonna have computer-based homework. It's all gonna be online. It's all gonna be on a screen, right? So get your eyes away from the screen and do something analog. Go play an instrument. You should be practicing your instrument anyway, students. Go play an instrument. Go paint. Go plant a garden, or maybe just a few pots of herbs or flowers to make your patio look prettier. If you don't have this kind of a hobby, now's a great time to develop one, to discover, well, I could try this and see if I like that. I could try this and see if I like that. But do something analog. Get off of the screen, okay? Don't take a break and play video games, because you're just putting yourself back into that same mindset and that same posture that you were when you were doing all your schoolwork. So go do something analog, away from your screen, away from your phone, away from your iPad. Go play your instrument. Lastly, I'm gonna leave you this. Remember that we are doing this to help keep each other's loved ones safer, okay? It won't last forever. We will get through this and it'll be okay, all right? In the meantime, I'm looking forward to seeing you at your lessons, and I expect that you should be practicing from week to week, and I will see all of you in person very soon. I just know it. Take care.